Hello students, welcome to my channel Science World, and if you find this video useful for you, then please like, comment and share with your friends. Also subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to get notification of my upcoming videos. Students, our today's topic is cloths that we wear. Okay, and cloths are very important for us. Why? That we will read today. Okay, so a good day starts with a refreshing bath and clean clothes. When you get up in the morning, the first thing that we do is bathing. We first clean our body and we wear clean clothes. Nobody want to wear dirty clothes, okay, because clean clothes make us feel fresh. Clean clothes make us feel fresh. But how was it in the early times? We have read about the early human beings. Look at here. Here, this is the early human beings picture. And they were not wearing any type of clothes, but what they used to wear long time ago, when early man was living in the caves. He was living in the caves. He covered his body with leaves, bark of trees and animal skin. Leaves, bark of trees. Barks mean bark is the outer covering of a stem of a tree. Okay, so bark of trees and animal skin they were using to cover their bodies. Here you can see this early human has wrapped himself in animal skin. Okay, man gradually learned the art of weaving cloth, followed by stitching it into garments. Gradually means slowly, dhire dhire. Okay, slowly man learned the art of weaving cloth. Weaving means bunna. Okay, to make the cloth. तो ये जो वीविंग का आर्ट है, स्लोली ही फाउंड आउट दैट आर्ट एंड देन इट इज़ फॉलोड बाय द स्टिचिंग इट इनटू गारमेंट्स एंड आफ्टर वीविंग मैन स्टार्टेड स्टिचिंग गारमेंट्स और क्लोथ्स फॉर हिमसेल्फ. ओके, क्लोथ्स आर एन इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ अवर लाइव्स नाउ. ओके, एंड वी वेयर क्लोथ्स फॉर प्रोटेक्शन from weather, dust and germs. See, there are different kind of weather conditions throughout the year. So when rainy season is there, we wear different clothes. In summer season, we wear different clothes. In winter season, we wear different clothes. Okay, so these clothes are important part of our lives. They also protect us from dust and germs. Clothes also make us look smart. Look at this boy, he is looking very smart in this clothes, and look at this early human, he has only animal skin on his body. Okay, so this clothes looks makes us look very smart. Then we live in a civilized society. Civilized society means well developed social life. We have well developed social life. That means daily we come in contact with many people. We go to school, we meet our friends, we go for parties, we go for marriages. Okay, our parents go for work, and that's why we wear different types of clothes suitable for our work that we do and the climate that we live in. So according to climate and whatever work we do, we decide our clothes. Okay, then we have choices of clothes. Okay, choices of clothes. So we wear clothes based on weather. The first thing, we wear clothes or we choose our clothes based on the weather. People wear different clothes in different weather conditions. Just now I told you, and in hot weather people wear clothes that keep that help to keep the body cool and dry, and that's why people wear cotton clothes in summer season. Okay, and cotton clothes are best for summers because they easily absorb the sweat. Sweat means pasina. तो जो कॉटन के क्लॉथ्स होते हैं वो पसीने को अच्छे से एब्जॉर्ब करते हैं. एब्जॉर्ब करते हैं मीन्स वो सोखते हैं, एंड दैट्स वाई वी वेयर कॉटन क्लॉथ्स. People also wear light colored clothes in this weather that reflect the heat. See, dark colored clothes attract heat or they absorb more heat, and that's why we wear light colored clothes in this weather, because light colored clothes reflect the heat. Okay, in cold places people wear woolen clothes to protect themselves from the cold. You must have noticed the people living in hilly areas. They wear layers of woolen cloths that shield their bodies from the chilling weather. See, woolen cloths are the cloths that are made from wool. These cloths are insulator. They act as insulator, means they do not allow our body heat to escape from the body. Means these woolen cloths keep our body warm, and that's why we are protected from the cold weather conditions. Okay, the warm air is trapped between the layers of these woolen cloths and we feel warm. Then during rainy season, what we wear? We wear raincoats made up of waterproof material. Waterproof material means water cannot penetrate or water cannot make them wet. Okay, waterproof materials are used to make raincoats and umbrellas. Okay, and they protect us from the rain. Now look at these pictures. Here this boy is wearing cotton cloths that is best suited in the summer. This boy has woolen cloths and it protects us from the cold weather. Okay, woolen cloths. Here this boy is wearing raincoat that protects us from the rain. We also choose our cloths based on the nationality or tradition. See, cloths are also worn as per the culture and traditions of a country. Many countries in the world consider some dresses as their national or traditional dresses. For example, sari is the traditional dress of India. Okay, sari is the traditional dress of Indian women. While kimono is the traditional dress of Japanese women. Japanese women wear kimono. It is their traditional dress. And hanbu. Hanbu is the traditional dress of China. Okay, hanbu is the traditional or national, both traditional and national dress of China. So we wear clothes that are based on the nationality or tradition. Then next we have clothes based on the profession. Clothes that are based on the profession. Profession means the work that we do to earn money. Okay, so you must have seen doctors and nurses in hospitals wearing white coats. Factory workers wear overalls and which cover their whole bodies. See, doctors and nurses, they wear white clothes, white coat over their clothes. Then these factory workers, they have overall covers their whole body. It is covered, these clothes cover their whole body, and that's why they are known as overalls. A soldier also wears a particular uniform. Soldier has its own uniform. Therefore, we see that some cloths define the professions of different people. That means cloths are worn by these uniforms. They are known as uniforms. So uniforms are worn by the people that are doing some special work. Okay, so different fabrics are also used in different types of cloths, and these uniforms or these cloths that different professionals wear, they are made from different types of fabrics also. Here you can see the picture. This is factory worker, this is a chef, then this is an architect, or we can say engineer. Okay, then this is a doctor and this is an advocate, okay, or lawyer. So these all have their own uniform. So you are also going in school and you wear your school uniform. So school different schools have different uniforms, so in this way we have seen that we choose clothes that are based on our profession or work. What work we do, it is shown by our clothes. See, traffic police has its own his own uniform, and doctors have their own uniforms, lawyers have their own uniforms. In this way, all these people that do this work, they have their own uniform. So today we have seen the importance of clothes and choice of the clothes. Okay, so we will meet in our next video with the cloth materials. Okay, different types of cloth material. Until then, take care. Bye bye.